startup Kheti was founded in 2015 by Ayush Sharma, Kaushik, Satya Raghu and Soumya. It is based in Hyderabad, Telangana, and the product name is Greenhouse in a Box. The technology used are greenhouse and protected cultivation. So what makes this startup interesting? So they follow a very simple rule, is that they will provide you a greenhouse and a drip irrigation system in just 2% of your land, or whatever farmers owns the land, just 2%, and it will cost 50% less than a regular greenhouse. So it is a very good thing. See, farmers are always complaining that they face harsh weather climate, uncertain risk with temperature, sudden rise in temperature, sudden fall in temperature, rainfall, hailstorm, other things. So the best option to grow good amount of crop is in a greenhouse, but greenhouses are costly. So these startups came up with an idea that we will provide the greenhouse, but at a 50% less cost. Plus, we'll not only provide a greenhouse, we'll provide a drip irrigation system also with them. And the best thing is, the farmers have to give a down payment of only rupees 30,000. The greenhouse developed by Kheti is 1,80,000. So where's the rest 1,50,000 coming from? Kheti startup has collaborations with Bank of Baroda and other investment agencies, where they provide loan to Kheti at a certain interest rate, or like 1,50,000. The loan will be given to the Kheti account, where the Kheti people will use it as according to their wish. They will be given a tenure of 3 years to repay the loan. So how they do repay the loan? The profit which is generated by selling the harvest which is done in the greenhouse. So it is a win-win situation for both of them. The farmer doesn't have a loan pressure. He has to just work hard and do good amount of harvest crops. So farmer will say, okay, you have set up me a protected cultivation kit, you have given me a drip irrigation system, you have told me about the crops also which to grow, but where do I sell? So Kheti startup does not stop there only with providing Kheti. They even make your links with farmer producer organizations and other market people, where you can go and sell your produce also. So it is not the Kheti like startups not just working in providing you the solution. They are going one step ahead and even ensuring that the farmer get good amount of prices. The impact is such that they have like 300 farmers who have already taken this protected cultivation scheme under Kheti. Coming to next is Krishi Hub. It was founded by Bhupendra in 2016 and the headquarters is in Bangalore, Karnataka. The product name is Krishi Hub mobile app. It is also one of the B2B e-commerce platform which uses artificial intelligence and mobile app platform. So Krishi Hub two sectors. One is agri supply chain, where they connect the farmers to the input dealers or forward the chain with wholesaler, retailers, consumers, vendors, whatever it is. But the another interesting part of this startup is agri advisory, and you can see 20,000 plus farmers on platform using the advisory services in 7 different languages. It is one of a good thing that a startup company has come up with in giving 7 different languages. Usually we find these apps in your English or Hindi, but they have come up with the app like, okay, we'll give you an agri advisory. So the farmers, I was able to talk to one of the farmers who was by chance sitting over there in the headquarters of the company. He was one of the successful farmers. You can term it as a progressive farmer. He told that his life has changed after using Krishi Hub, because first of thing, he is able to sell his produce using the Krishi Hub platform. He is able to get good inputs also in time. He is able to get the pesticide or fertilizer, whatever the plant protection inputs. And moreover that, he is getting advisory services from consultants and scientists who are based in universities like agriculture research agencies and all. So this shows that Krishi Hub is going ahead and they are having collaboration with certain universities where the good scientists and experts can act as a consultant to these firms, and they can give advices to farmers on time to time, like when there's a disease pest attack, when there's a low yield, how can they increase it and everything. So this thing, as you can see, the agri supply chain is usually based in Uttar Pradesh, the state of Uttar Pradesh only, but the agri advisory service is being done pan India, like everyone is. On the funding part, they didn't reveal their funds, but the thing was they got funding from IIT Kanpur Invent Accelerator and Wilgrow Innovation Fund, along with few angel investors and HNIs. Next coming to is NinjaGuard. You must have heard like this about this startup. It is one of the most famous startups right now in India, working on B2B platform. They have changed the game of supply chain. Like these have like taken the supply chain onto a next level. It was founded in 2015 by 6 founders, which are Ashok, Ashutosh, Karthikeswaran, Sharad, Tirukuram and Vasudevan. Active regions are there, working in Bangalore, Chennai and Hyderabad. There you can see that how they work. Their first thing is forecasting, followed by pricing. Next is farmer harvesting, collection centers, fulfillment center, distribution centers, and end to retailer. This Ninja Cart startup connects the farmer to the retailer, not to the final consumer, like common people, but till the retailer. So when I talked to them, they told about this thing is forecasting. First, they will forecast about the produce, like how much is required by the market. Okay, like this much amount of this particular crop is required, or this much amount of, they will forecast it beforehand, and then they give this, analyze the data based on previous history, like what is the consumer demand, what is the new crop that has been demanded in the factor. They will take 3 or 4 factors into consideration. Before like 1 week of final delivery of the thing, they will again do this forecasting re-channel again, and then again they will confirm about the demands of the retailers. It's not that maybe 1-2 week or 1 month ago retailer demanded something, but they need to confirm it again. Based on that forecasting, they will generate prices based on different scope of the market, like what is the wholesale price, what is the retailer price, what is the best price they can offer to their own farmers who are attached with the app. After the prices are set on an average basis, which is like best for the retailer also and for the farmer also. Farmer harvesting, they will send the amount of like how much kgs or how much tons of harvest are required on the app, which is with mobile, like on the smartphone, which is with the farmer. They have a special app like devised for the farmer, where they will receive, okay, this much is the amount that we require. Farmer harvestist and farmer are also trained in sorting and grading by Ninja Cart people. Ninja Cart have maintained their own sorting and grading criteria, but they have not called any personnel. They have like you have to sort and you have to grade. They have even trained their own farmers. Okay, you can do it easily because it's not very tough. They told like their farmers, it's not very tough to do sorting and grading. So the farmer does the sorting and grading. After that, the farmer takes the produce to the collection centers, where they are collected, weighed, and a receipt is generated to the farmer. Okay, this was your amount, this was the amount of money that you have got. After that, from the collection center, all the produce are taken to the fulfillment center, where they are distributed, again weighed, again repacked, and all things are done. After the distribution, like fulfillment center, they are taken to distribution centers, where the produce are distributed according to the retailers, like which retailers are there and which not. The interesting thing was also that all these things are being tracked as it is being done. One person, they have to entry on their particular mobile. If the person is there in collection center, he has to enter into the mobile that, okay, we have received this much amount of produce from this farmer and everything. So you have to see that from the forecasting to the end, everything is being tracked by the Ninja Cart people. After the distribution center, the produce have been distributed into the particular trucks which has to go. The drivers of the trucks are given with a smartphone which have the address and the retailers. One particular driver will have only those addresses which fall into his route. He doesn't have to change the route. So that saves time, that saves money, and it is very fast to deliver. So the drivers deliver it to retailer. And the best thing is, while coming back from delivery also, they take the cash money from the retailer. So they are generating the, like, they're giving the produce, and while coming back from back to the distribution, they collect the cash also. So the, and all these things, you can see, it is done in less than 12 hours. So that is a very good one. Usually what happens, we have to wait 1 day or 2 days for the fresh produce to come. But they are doing it less than 12 hours. And it was very interesting to note, before the opening of, like in the morning, when you're going to buy vegetable and fruits, fresh vegetable and fruits are with the retailers. So you're getting fresh vegetables, farmers are getting their prices within 24 hours of their selling the produce. So they have made effective the whole system. Right now they have raised a Series B funding of 34.6 million by ASL US, Syngenta Ventures, Neoplux, Zigzen founders Joe Hayaro, HR Capital, Trifecta Capital, Nandan Nilekani, and Qualcomm Ventures. These are the major investors who are working in the field, like working behind startup Ninja Cart. Next one is Thanos Technologies. I would like to discuss, this is based in Hyderabad. This was founded in 2016. It is, you can, if you will ever get a chance during your orientation program, do visit IIIT Hyderabad, where one incubation center is there, and you will find this startup based over there. This startup was founded by Harish and like other members. They told that the major problem, you know what, is like spraying pesticide. It is causing harm to the farmers. They have to carry this backpack of 30 to 40 liters and it is not uniform on the field also. They are not proper measuring the thing also. So they came up with an idea that we'll use drone for spraying the thing. So what they do is they have made their in-home drone which carries 15 to 20 liters of spray at one time. You have to do is you have to contact these people through app or on through a website. You call them, you have this thing meeting, okay, I want my field to be sprayed. They will go to your field, they will map the field, they will do everything for you. You just have to pay on the very least amount which is there. The prices, I can't reveal the prices right now because it was asked by them. But the thing is, like, the prices are very remunerative. Like, it's very cheap. It's not very tough also. And the best thing is, farmer is not getting any harm by them. Usually, we see that maximum accident that poisoning is done by pesticide while spraying also. And Indian farmers don't take that much care while spraying. So it's better we use a drone and do it. The impact has, like, the stage is in opening. Not every farmer is adapting this thing, but till now there have 25 farmers have utilized the services and they have covered 180 acres under commercial farming. So this is also one of the good Thanos technologies. Another one is V-Drone. V-Drone is based in Bangalore, Karnataka. It was founded by Kunal Sharma and Pranam Manpuria. They initially started with a simple drone company, which is like into other fields of sector, like IT sectors and everything. But they saw that there's a lot of scope in drone mapping in agriculture sector. So they have developed their own drone through which they generate crop health and other factors through a simple mapping of the drone. They take around some good amount of, they will get your thing prices for the thing. Mapping of the drone, and right now 500 farmers have used the services in Karnataka. They will generate you the report and they'll tell which part of the crop is not healthy and which part of your soil needs certain nutrition and all those things. Coming to last one is UTX Technologies. It was founded by Rajiv Jha in 2013. It installs automatic weather station, air quality stations, wireless data logger and sensor catalog. This particular startup is not only working in the field of agriculture, but in working to different sectors like cities and commercial areas where pollution level is increasing and everything. That it is very difficult to monitor climate changes and everything. What they do is, you can see, they install their own sensor, which is given in the figure. They install their own sensor on the houses, like right now, there are 12 automatic weather stations working in Bangalore. They generate results from it. They analyze the result and then provide the results to the particular weather station, like with the matching it with the data from IMD, and then they give it to the farmers, like whether these things need to be planted or not, or whether these crops is good, you need to irrigate, you have good moisture content and everything. So right now they have 15 plus weather station established, active regions of Bengaluru, Chennai, Hyderabad and Ooty, and they didn't disclose their funding. Coming to the third part of the research was startup policy and implementation by central and state governments to boost Indian startup ecosystem. The Department of Industrial Policy and Promotion has been actively taking requisite measures to encourage entrepreneurship and promote innovation. The Government of India has launched Startup India. From when you visit the site and see, they have made 22 regulatory reforms, right from the 2016 to 2018 at the moment. Right now, we are hearing one of the news, like in 2019, we were expecting that angle tax. It is one of the issue by startups. Everyone has raised that angle tax is 30% right now in India, and it is causing the investors to back out from the investing in Indian startups. So all the startups in the community has asked the government to look into this matter and decrease the tax as much as possible. And to promote agriculture sector, the Startup India program policy also hosted agriculture grand challenge. It was based on 12 themes. When you visit on the site, you can see the 12 themes. What are the 12 themes? Like assaying and sorting, problem of e-financing, e-commerce, paddy straw management technique, alternative to pesticide. These were like the 12 themes that were generated. You can go and see the results, which startups came as winner of the thing. Coming to role of state governments, only 4 state governments were actively supporting startups before the launch of Startup India. You can see before 2016, Andhra Pradesh, Kerala, Rajasthan and Goa were having only startup policy to implement good thing. But after Startup India was launched in January of 2016, you can see 22 states have their own startup policies now. They are actively taking part and increasing it. And to further promote, like, which state is working best in startup and the Department of Industrial Policy and Promotion conceived the state startup ranking framework. It was based on 7 parameters, which are startup policy and implementation, incubation hubs, seed funding support angle and venture funding support, simplified regulations, easing public procurement, awareness and outreach. When you visit the Startup India site, there's a full report working. Full report is generated by the Startup India, like which state has performed well in which of these 7 parameters. So you can say, like, if you, I guess you people are from different states, and on that report you can also see which state has made certain policy changes. So you will be aware of that thing when you are starting your own firm. Recommendations that came from this research were, first of all, is lack of farmers' usage about smartphone leads to marginal utilization of the startup services. Every startup complained this thing. Although, because maximum of their apps are mobile based, smartphone based, and still our farmer are not that much aware. So the recommendation from this study came that instead of promoting startup at the moment, it is going on, it's very well good. Simultaneously, we should train our farmer in using smartphone, the basic features. We don't want them to start using smartphone and this and that for another high level. We just want them so that they can make their account, they can access the smartphone, they can access the app. Okay, the companies, the startup which have mobile application, they are doing it. They are training their own farmers into using them. But that is not enough. Any company will do how much? Like 200, 300 farmers. Na? Still a lot of farmers are left. So on this thing, the training institutes, organization, agencies can start a new program which will help in training the farmer in smartphone. Secondly, startup face a lot of problem regarding the awareness and outreach. Many of us didn't know, even I also tell you, before starting this, I knew few of them, the name of few startups. After research, I got to know that there are more than 400 startups working in the field of agriculture. So we need one common platform where these startups can be listed, and not only listed, they can be listed whether they're active or not. Some of the time we find list, but when we go to access those startup on the website, they're not working at all. So we need a common unified platform where farmers are also able to access information about these startups. Secondly, need for the government to help set up agri-tech focused incubator. There are a lot of incubators, more than 200 incubators are there, but how much are focused on agri-tech? That is the problem. Still, investors, incubators, accelerators are backing from the agri-tech sector because they think that revenues are not generated fast enough. It is true, it takes time to generate revenue in agri-tech sector, but that doesn't mean that we cannot invest in developing infrastructure for it. So we need to develop infrastructure in focusing agri-tech. Banks and financial organizations also need to step up to the challenge. Like, we always looking investment fund from where? Angle investors, family, friends or fools. We are looking for venture capital or investment, but we are not looking for any particular startup like banks. When we go to banks to start company, our financial, we are not allowed for the taking. So the banks also need to work certain policy on this thing where they can fund these startups. So it will be a good thing. There will be less running away for I am not getting fund, I am not getting fund. That's the thing. Secondly, and last, startups should emphasize more on small and marginal farmers who form the majority in Indian agriculture. Why this recommendation came? The reason being that after everything, startup is still a private entity. Startup is still trying to generate its revenue. Startup is still trying to fund its thing. So they need revenue, they need money. But money will not always come for small and marginal farmer because it is very difficult to manage them. They have less amount of land, they have less produce. So what helps, like what ultimately happens, they have to go with large and medium farmers. So if they're working with large and medium farmers only, the problem still persists because the majority problem is with the small and marginal farmer, which is almost 85% of the population. So the startups also need to focus more on small and marginal farmers. Concluding this particular session, it's like a total of 366 agri-based startups have come up from 2013 to 2017. The major sectors are big data analytics, supply chain, market link and model, FASS, IoT enabled, engineering led innovation, and miscellaneous other sectors. From ICT apps to farm automation, and from weather forecasting to drone use, and from farm inputs retailing and equipment renting to online vegetables marketing, they do all and everything. Like, the startups have not left any sector. They are working in each sector. But the only thing is, how much each sector is being given focus. We saw that from the data, like 60% of startups are working in supply chain. We don't need that. If
certain startups can handle majority part of the India supply chain, why we need 63% of the whole startups in that? We can also focus on other sectors where it can be helped. Like we always have a problem, you must have heard, last mile delivery failure. Last mile delivery failure means to the last farmer or to the last kilometer, we are not able to reach them. So we need to work also on this thing where we can take the information from lab to the land. And on in the end, selling products and technology to farmer is widely recognized as a big channel. It is true. Because whenever these startups were telling, whenever you take the product to farmers, na, they will ask, sir, you have a subsidy on this thing or whether you are giving it for free. So we need to remove that thing also from their mind, mentality. Not everything is free. Yeah, we can provide them at a cheaper cost, obviously, because they are farmers. They are not getting that much of profit. But we also, it becomes a challenge. So we need to make the whole startup or your product or service farmer oriented, not technology oriented, but farmer oriented. So in the end, I would like to end the session with a simple line. Sell your problem, not the product. Sell the problem that you are issuing, not the product. If you're selling the product, no one will buy it. But if you're selling the problem that you're solving, that is the most important thing. Thank you.
So I have two questions.
Sure.
As a beginner, I wanted to know the what's the difference between the incubators and accelerators. And another question is how to get in touch with the angle investors.
Okay. So answering to the first question, like what is the difference between incubators and accelerators? Accelerators comes, their role come into play when you are like established the startup, you're working on this thing, like you're maybe you're moved from first stage, second stage, you're on to third or fourth stage, but you are stuck on certain problem. After certain probing and also still you're not getting out of that problem, then the role of accelerators come. You meet with this accelerator, you meet with this agency or entity, and you tell them about the problem. And then they help you to come out of that problem. So that is what, they give acceleration to your startup. They accelerate to you from that problem. Usually acceleration is like from 3 to 12 months. It's not more than that. It takes like between 3 to 12 months. On the basis of incubator, on like when we come to incubator, you have an idea. But you don't have the resources to generate your idea. You don't have mentoring. You need certain people to guide you. Like how can you make the idea into a business or into a product? There the role of incubation comes. Incubation is where you can meet mentors. You can meet people who are from different startups. And they will help you to generate your idea into a product. Usually incubation is from 3 to 36 months. So that is like the longer period where you can act as an incubator. Coming on to the list of angle investors, see, there are certain things like you can search for the angle investors on internet, like who are the famous angle investors who are working into this field. Other, the best thing is when you are working with certain like incubation center, they are the best source. They can automatically link you with angle investors and potential investors who are in the field.
Sir, how can I get seed fund for my startup?
Seed fund?
Yeah.
See, seed. The thing is like if you're working under an incubation, they will generally they will link you with the seed investors who are ready to fund your thing. But seed fund is, it can be done from two way. One, you generate your product, you generate your idea, like minimum viable product. You are ready to show, okay, this product will have this effect and then, and you can go directly to the seed investors. You can have appointment, you can pitch your idea to them, and if they like it, they will fund it. Otherwise, the best sources. See, the thing is, many of these startups, people are, na, some of them are very equipped with the knowledge beforehand only that, okay, we have to go there, someone has guided. But the best I will like suggest is to go under an incubation center and they will link you with everything, potential investors, they will link you with other networks, they will link you with market linkages and create everything. So the best thing is go under an incubation center or search for better seed funders because there's always list being generated from everywhere. From different internet sources, from secondary. You can search for the startups in your sector also who have funded them and you can take the idea to them also. If they like that, okay, your idea is a bit different from the startup they are already funding, they will invest in you. So, that's the thing.
So, sir, state government or in Startup India is providing seed fund?
Yeah, they are providing seed fund. They have created certain funds which is called as Fund of Funds, FFS. They have created funds of funds, and that even central government and certain state governments have allotted good amount of money, like 100 crores, 250 crores. They are ready to fund you if their idea is good. Under RKVA Raftar also, if you're working under RKBA Rafta, you come for an orientation course, if your idea is viable, you can be granted a good amount of money from RKBA Rafta also.
Excuse me, sir.
Yeah.
So is there any startup working towards sourcing of funds, that is bank finance or various grants and subsidies available to the farmer?
Like in the agriculture sector, sir, the secondary data I got was 1%.
Yeah.
But I have got the I don't remember the name exactly, but I will tell you there are not much startups who are working for providing subsidies or funds to the farmers. That is the most difficult part. So I was not able to like get ahead or get hold of those startups also. So that is the thing. I exactly can't tell you which startups are working to that field.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Any more questions? Okay, then thank you very much. We'll end the session here. Thank you for your patience and thank you for your listening. Okay, thank you very much.